What's up, guys? Welcome back to Financial Hacks, your one-stop shop on how to make money in this new digital age, and also how to have the correct mindset so you can succeed. In today's episode, we'll be going over the good old Chase Unlimited card. And if you haven't already, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay connected on this financial journey. So before I even started on working on this video, I actually thought I had the Chase Freedom Unlimited card. Apparently, I didn't. I actually had this one right here, the original. As you can see, I may put that on the screen there. Yeah, covering up the numbers, but yeah, this is the Chase Freedom regular card. Apparently, they ended up having the Chase Unlimited and then the Chase Flex. So my Freedom card would be in the middle. So thankfully, I am eligible for the Chase Freedom Unlimited card. So after this video, I will end up going ahead and getting that, and then probably doing like another video like 3 months from now, talking about my pros and cons of having the card actually for 3 months. But anyways, we'll be going over the stats of this card directly from their website. We'll be going over the facts and any other info we can find on this card. And then I'll give my final say if I think this is a good card to get or a not so good card to get. All right, so let's go ahead and go over the pros and cons and I guess details that we can see for this Chase Freedom Unlimited card. So first off, the big thing right here is that the $200 bonus plus 5% cashback grocery store offer. Now let's go ahead and go over this. You can earn a $200 bonus after you spend $500 on purchases in the first 3 months from account opening. And we got the asterisk. And earn 5% cash back on grocery store purchases, not including Target or Walmart purchases. So if you're a person who just goes to Target or Walmart primarily, you may not end up getting that much on up to $12,000 spent in the first year. And we got another asterisk there. This product is available to you if you do not have this card and have not received a new member card for this card in the past 24 months. Okay. So, I mean, that's pretty cool. $200 bonus plus 5% cash back on grocery store offer. Again, if you are a person who primarily goes to Target or Walmart, you may miss out on some of that. But if you are a heavy spender, you know, period, within that first month, getting that extra $200 bonus for actually spending $500 on things you would already spend $500 on, I think that can definitely be a good thing there. Next up, we have the earn cash back. So for the first one, we have earn 5% on travel purchase through Chase Ultimate Rewards. Okay, earn 3% on dining at restaurants, including takeout and eligible delivery services. Okay, I'm hoping that also includes Uber Eats and DoorDash. Earn 3% on drugstore purchases. And earn 1.5% on all other purchases. This is pretty cool again. The cool thing about the cashback on cards is that it's pretty much just free money that you're getting back. So, this one has, you know, a pretty standard one for the most part. For the earn 1.5% on all purchases, I'm used to seeing maybe like 1% or sometimes 0%, and maybe they'll have like 3% on gas, for example, or 3 or 2% at the store. So for the fact that you do get 1.5% on all other purchases, 3% already on drugstore, dining at restaurants, this part is definitely going to be weird with this whole COVID situation. But hey, after we're done with that, you know, that will be a great option. But the fact that it also includes takeout, that's also pretty cool. And this one, if you are a big traveler, getting that extra 5% back, before long, you'll be able to get yourself some free trips. So I'm definitely liking what I'm seeing on the earn cash back. Now, low intro APR. 0% intro APR for 15 months from account opening on purchases. After the intro period, a variable APR of 14.99% to 23.74%. Okay. Now, if you guys do have higher credits, I'm pretty sure you'll be closer to this 15 mark. I'm pretty sure you'll be closer to maybe what, 15, 16, 17. So that is kind of, I guess, on the higher side in a sense compared to some of the debit cards. But for a credit card,
I mean, that is pretty standard for the most part. I am liking this 0% intro APR for 15 months. That is definitely cool. My current Chase Freedom card, I don't believe I actually had a 15 month free interest period. So the fact that this one comes with 15 months, so you get yourself a year and some months, that's definitely cool. Again, I always recommend you paying off your credit card every month, or at least every week or every couple of weeks. But hey, you know, things may happen. And for the fact that you will have that low intro APR for 15 months, you can go ahead and buy me that PlayStation 5, and you don't have to worry about paying interest on that. Next up, no annual fee. You won't have to pay an annual fee for all the great features that come with your Freedom Unlimited card. This is great here. I don't really believe in paying an annual fee for the credit card unless you're getting like an insane amount of points or something like that. So for the fact that this card does have the zero intro APR for 15 months, so you don't have to worry about that interest for the first 15 months, and you're not worrying about paying any type of annual fee using the card, like with some of the other ones I've seen for like $95, for example, that's always a good thing there. Next up, we have the cash back rewards do not expire. I like that already. Cash back rewards do not expire as long as your account is open, and there is no minimum to redeem for cash back. Definitely liking this one. The first thing that caught my eye is this part, the do not expire. Some cards, they do expire yearly, or maybe after a couple years. So for the fact that you can just save up all your points for this year, next year, 2023, 2024, and so on, and still keep those points to buy something, that's always great. And then there's no minimum to redeem for cash back. I like this too, because on a lot of different cards I've seen, you may have to get maybe $10 or maybe $25 or maybe $50. Heck, I've seen some, not necessarily cards, but I've seen other like services where you get to wait until you get to $100 before you get cash back. So for the fact that there's no minimum, that's always cool. So hey, if you wanted to get that extra $10 or $20 real quick, you don't have to actually worry about getting up to $25 or up to $50 before you receive that. So that's pretty cool. I'm liking that a lot. And then we have this feature here, refer friends. If you already have a Chase Freedom Unlimited card, earn up to $500 cash back per year. You can earn $100 cash back for each friend that gets approved for any participating Chase Freedom card when you click this button. Refer friends now. Okay, this is cool. You know what, guys? I may end up getting that affiliate link and linking this directly in the description box below and in the pinned comments. So yeah, be on the lookout for that. I may end up trying that out. Again, I do plan on actually getting this card. I'm liking everything I'm seeing so far, and I probably will end up doing a video of my thoughts after having the card for a few months. And let's go ahead and go over the FAQs real quick. Can you have Chase Freedom Unlimited in Chase Freedom Flex? Yes, you can have both the Chase Freedom Flex and the Chase Freedom Unlimited credit cards. That's cool. I actually don't have the Unlimited or the Flex. I have just a regular one. So I wonder how that applies to this. I'm pretty sure I can still keep my main card, but I guess I'll see. I definitely wouldn't mind upgrading to the Unlimited if I needed to. Next up, does Chase Freedom Unlimited have travel insurance? The Chase Freedom Unlimited credit card offers trip cancellation interruption insurance for eligible purchases made with your Chase Freedom Unlimited credit card. You can be reimbursed up to $1,500 per person and $6,000 per trip for your prepaid non-refundable passenger fares. If your trip is canceled or cut short by sickness, severe weather, and other covered situations. Okay, it looks okay. I mean, it looks pretty good. I don't really have any complaints, nor am I really versed in actually canceling or getting reimbursement from our trips. How to get cash back with the Chase Freedom Unlimited credit card. The Chase Freedom Unlimited card awards 1.5% cash back for every $1 spent on all purchases beginning September 13, 2020. You can also earn unlimited 5% cash back on travel purchases made through Chase Unlimited, Chase Ultimate Rewards, and 3% cash back on dining purchases at restaurants, including takeout and eligible delivery services and drugstores. Through March 2020, card members can also earn 5% cash back on all Lyft rides. Cash back points can be redeemed through Ultimate Rewards with no minimum. Okay, again, liking the cashback options like I was talking about earlier. We do see this extra part through March 2020. Card members can also earn 5% cash back on all Lyft rides. So yeah, if you are an Uber driver, or I mean a type of person, you may want to end up switching with Lyft with this credit card just for you, just for the fact that you get that extra 5%, which can definitely add up a lot if you're using Lyft a lot. What are the new Chase Freedom Unlimited cash back benefits? Freedom Unlimited card members will earn 5% cash back on all travel. Okay, yeah, that we saw this one. 3% cash back restaurants, we saw that, and 3% cash back on drugstore, and yeah, the 1.5% on all other purchases, and no annual fee. Yeah, again, I'm liking those. Pretty standard. I would say this one is maybe slightly even better than a lot of the other standard ones I've seen, just for the fact that you don't have to choose. Like, I've actually had to choose on my Bank of America card, which I may end up doing a video on. So for the fact that you don't have to choose and you automatically get this 1.5% cash back on all other purchases outside of your 5% on travel, 3% on dining, and the 3% on drugstore purchases, this is definitely cool there. And how do I get the new Chase Freedom Unlimited cash back rewards? Beginning September 13th, 2020, all new Freedom Unlimited customers will get the new cash back rewards. So yeah. This is actually after September 13th when we're recording this video. It isn't too far from September 13th. So I think that was like what, last week sometime. So hey, yeah, if you're looking at this video right now, you should be eligible for the new cashback rewards if you already have the card, or if you do want to get you know, those rewards for the card. And then we got some of the reviews. This is some reviews from the actual people. Apparently, but this was also on the Chase website. So if we're going to be looking at reviews, I think it's better to look at a site that's not affiliated with Chase. And lastly, let's just go ahead and just bring up the pricing and terms real quick. And, you know, kind of just look at everything, give us like a one quick view. I won't be reading everything on this, but I'll be going over any of the highlights that I see. Like, for example, as we've seen in the other one, the 0% intro APR for 15 months, I like that, that your account is open. Out of that, 14.99 to 23.74. Again, this is okay. I mean, I usually see, you know, this range, at least around this range for credit cards. Again, if you're on the channel, we're not going to be in debt. So we're not, you know, we're not going to be actually worrying about actually paying back 14.99% or 24%. And again, as you see here, it's based on your credit worthiness. Balance transfer, okay, again, 14.99 to 23.74. All right, so yeah, if you do plan on doing some balance transfers, you will be pretty much around the same amount as your APR for that, so that there's no change on that. Cash advance APR, 24.99%. Of course, yeah, usually for the cash advances, those are always higher, so for that one being slightly higher than this, at, you know, looks pretty standard. Your due date will be minimum of 21 days after the close of each billing cycle. You will not charge your interest on a new purchase if you pay your entire balance. Okay, that looks pretty standard as well. Get the 21 days after your close of your each billing cycle. And we got the 0% amount of purchase to create my Chase plan. Okay, 1.2%. Okay, that looks pretty good. Either $5, 5% cash, whichever greater, for balance transfers, 10 or 15, whichever. Okay. Okay, now for late payments, yeah, let's go ahead and look over the penalty fees real quick. We have a up to $39 late payment. I mean, again, if you're on the channel, we're not paying stuff late, we're paying stuff early. So, I mean, 39 isn't too bad. Over the credit limit, none. Okay, you know, that's pretty cool. Return payment, up to $39. Again, we're hopefully, you know, you're not hitting those penalty fees, but I'm liking how it's pretty much none and 39, or up to $39, instead of having like some convoluted type of penalty payment system. So I'm liking that it's pretty much just straight up right there. Okay, you get your prime rate, check, calculate your balance, military lending act notice. If you're in the military, you may want to go ahead and read that. You may actually get some benefits there. Raising fees. And yeah, right now, again, we're not going to be reading all of this right now. I may end up reading some of this prior to me actually getting the card in a bit. But yeah, guys, that is the info for the Chase Freedom Unlimited card.
So yeah, overall, I think this is a great card to get, especially if you are on the Chase network. Might as well go ahead and, you know, get a slightly higher card without having to worry about the $95 annual fee like in this other card. Now for myself, I had good luck with the original Chase Freedom card, this one right here. Never really had any issues. I actually did make a video talking about, you know, the pros and cons of having or primarily using just one credit card. And yeah, that card I was mainly talking about in that video that I actually use most of the time, and, you know, to have all my points and all that for all the fun stuff I had, it was using that card. So overall, if you are able to get the original Freedom card, you might as well get that one too. Now, once I do end up getting the unlimited version for this card, I probably will end up making a, maybe 3 months from now, kind of going over the pros and cons of actually having the card and using it, if I do see anything, you know, worthwhile sharing with you guys. But overall, I think it's a great card to get. And if you are eligible to go ahead and get it, you might as well go ahead and try. Anyways, guys, if you haven't already, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe and stay tuned for some more videos either this week or next week. See you soon.